Flash today. Don't miss a huge Mega Millions drawing tonight at 11.
From WBAL-TV 11, this is an InstaWeather Plus alert.
Good morning, I'm Mindy Becerra. It's 10 o'clock. We want to give you an update on the current conditions outside following the snowstorm. Kim Dacey is live on Falls Road in northwest Baltimore, but let's start with meteorologist Ava Marie in Catonsville. Ava, what's happening there right now?
It's still snowing right now. The snowflakes are just ever so tiny. They're really having a hard time sticking anymore. We started the snow at 6:30 this morning, but since then we've only accumulated about an inch and a half, and that's mostly on the sidewalks and the parking lots, not so much the roads. You can see a Route 40 and Rolling Road, the intersection behind me. This is a little ramp that goes from Rolling Road onto Route 40, and it's doing fine. I mean, traffic's doing okay. It's been at a steady speed throughout the entire morning. Granted, people are being a little bit cautious because of the slush that's in between the lanes. There you have some plows background there. They're pushing all the slush off the main drive part, and then it's going off into the curb. So just allow some space as those roads continue to get cleared by the crews. But I am so impressed by the roads here in Catonsville. Not once did we see them completely iced over. They have been wet, if not slushy, this entire morning as we continue to get the light snow. But as you look on the radar, the back edge of it is starting to creep towards the Baltimore metro area, which means the end of the snow is almost near. So what you have now, besides a couple of bursts of snow, this is about what we're going to get. We've seen a range of about 1 to 5 across the area, a little bit more up towards the Pennsylvania line. But Tony will have more information coming up on that. Here we have the plows coming on by right on Route 40. We're going to go now to Kim Dacey, who's in Baltimore City. And how much do you have now?
We have a little over an inch, maybe as much as an inch and a half. We've got a dusting kind of all over the grass and also all over the trees. And then the roads, of course, we want to show you Falls Road and Cold Spring Lane. Falls Road is here behind me, and it's just kind of a slushy mess. We did just see a plow go by as well here, but still leaving a slushy mess as the snow continues to fall. So definitely leave yourself some extra time if you're going to be out on the roads this morning. It's going to be a slow go out there. Again, it's very slick, slushy, just kind of gross out there on the roads. The snow that's coming down now is kind of a fine, very fine snow, like Ava was describing, not accumulating very much, but very thin, very fine, fine snowflakes here. It's making for a great packing snow. So if for all the kids out there who are off of school, it's great, great weather to make a snowball or a snowman. Mindy, back into you.
All right, thank you very much, Kim. And right now, there are about 1,500 BGE customers without power. Nearly all of those outages happened within the last 3 hours, which is around when that snow started falling. Now, let's get a look at what the current track of the storm is. Tony, is it moving out?
Yeah, over the next couple of hours, things are really going to taper off. I certainly wouldn't call this a high-impact storm by any means. You could see on most of those live shots, the roads were okay. Here are some of the snowfall totals I have into the weather office. Thanks again to everybody on Facebook and Twitter for sending these in. We have about 2 inches here on TV Hill, 3.5 at Westminster, Towson, a little over 2 inches. Thurmont, that's in the northern part of Frederick County, closer to 4 inches there. Columbia, 2.5. Most of you are going to be in that 1 to 3 inch range with this storm, with the higher amounts in the far northern and western suburbs. Here's a look at the radar. We still have a few little stripes of heavier snow or moderate snow. You got one up around Westminster right now, another one near the airport in Anne Arundel County. Most of you are in that light gray shading, which is light snow, more like snow flurries. And as Ava mentioned, you can see the back edge of the precipitation already coming up out of the mountains just to the west of the D.C. suburbs there. So if we time this out, it'll take maybe another 2 hours for the bulk of the storm to get through. And most of that between now and the end of the storm will be light snow or snow flurries with just a few bands of moderate snow in there. So that's our forecast by 11 o'clock, light to moderate snow still, maybe a little sleet or rain mixing in south of Baltimore. Then by 1 o'clock in the afternoon, it'll just be snow flurries. Storm totals range anywhere from 1 to maybe 5 inches in those far northern and western suburbs. Again, most of you will be closer to the 2 or 3 inch amount. And then by 3 o'clock this afternoon, it should be mostly cloudy. I mean, if we're lucky, we might even get a peek at the sun later today to help out the road crews with the evening commute. But it should be dry for the evening commute with temperatures in the mid-30s. That's the way I see it right now. Let's send it over to Sarah, see what's happening out there on the roads. Hi, Sarah.
All right, thanks, Tony, and good morning, everyone. Well, as the system continues to pass through, we're dealing with not only accidents around the area, but some marked train delays we want to tell you about. Train 849, 50 minutes behind schedule, and that's due to the accident along Hollins Ferry. We'll remind you of that in a moment. Also want to let you know that both the Penn and Camden line operating on an S schedule beginning at 10:30 this morning, so check on your schedules there. Holland's Ferry at Paca Street remains closed due to an accident involving a train and a car. Those lanes will remain closed for a while, so we're suggesting Washington Boulevard as your alternate. South Bend 95 just getting word of an accident at Caton Avenue. Let's take a live look in that area. Looks like the left lane at least is taken up, and it is causing some delays. And you can see the continued downfall of snow coming down in the area. Franklin Town at Edmondson, watch for a bus accident, reportedly an MTA bus involved in that. And then further north in Freeland, Gore Mill Road at Middletown Road, a vehicle over an embankment, and police remain on the scene there. Franklin, in that area, along Route 27 and Liberty Road, we have an overturned vehicle as well. A live picture, this is showing 83 in the Parkton region, where traffic is okay, but obviously not a lot of folks out there on the roads, which is a good thing. We continue to suggest that you stay home, and if you don't have to be out on the roads, just enjoy being at home for at least the next few hours while the system passes through. Thanks for joining us. That's the latest on Traffic Pulse 11. We'll see you back here for a live hour-long newscast at noon.